In Baltimore, we took care of business.
Go ahead.
And the reason that we took care of business and got justice for Freddie Gray is because we came out strong.
That's right.
Now to Baltimore, where protesters have been scuffling with police today.
The anger filled the street from curb to curb on Saturday, the crowd large and loud as they marched 3 miles to Baltimore City Hall. The protesters are demanding to know what happened to Freddie Gray, who died after a week in a coma.
Ah!
Police still have not said specifically why he was stopped or what happened after this now infamous video showed police dragging him into a van.
Our police employees failed to get him medical attention in a timely manner multiple times.
Mayor Stephanie Rawlings Blake.
The officers know better. So the fact that they didn't follow procedure and we are here again having to explain to a mother why she has to bury her child is unacceptable.
We are not the enemies. I'm tired of seeing this. It's too much. It's gone too far. And all I'm begging them to do is hold these cops accountable.
Why did the governor Governor Markell come last week to Bethel AME Church and ask for an apology for slavery? And at this time, knowing that this hot issue is on the table of getting justice for our brother Jeremy, why come now? What are you saying? Why are you apologizing? But you, my governor, have to do more than apologize. It has to be an atonement for that of just saying sorry. That's not going to get it. And so we need to sit down and talk about this thing because it's bigger than I'm just saying sorry. And then I say to the clergy, don't have him go around and you present him to our people in order that they can soothe over what is happening here in the black community with our brother Jeremy.
The only problem we really got right now is with the police. If we're going to unite black people, we need to unite and fight against the police. And when I say fight, I don't mean to go hand in hand with them. It's spiritual. This is a spiritual war.
That's right. That's
when you're dealing with spiritual warfare, you got to know how to engage your enemy. Right now, we're doing it civilly.
That's right.
The Constitution says that we can protest anything we want as long as we do it civil.
That's right.
So what we're doing is civil.
Right.
But what I want the city preachers to know, what I want the city politicians to know, is where the hell are y'all at?
Right.
I want y'all to know, don't be ashamed, and you don't owe nobody apology for thinking black, talking black, walking black, living black. You are black. Stand up to it, hold it, and don't let nobody try to do nothing against it.
We're gathered here as a community of people on behalf of a nation, so understand there is a bigger cause underlying this situation. In the case of the murder of my brother, Jeremy McDowell, under the laws that are attributed to us and which we are governed by, they released a more than suspect 911 call, first of all. What about your promises, Mayor?
But we will get to the bottom of this. We want answers just like you want answers.
You promised action, transparencies. We the people are still waiting for action to be taken. It's been over a month, Mayor. I don't know if you're here. But other than a bunch of talk, we the people don't know of anything you've done to advance this case. And so we take action today. We march. We demand answers. Simply, we demand justice, so we're marching today and we're standing out here.
Oh, don't go and talk about my father. Talk about my father. God is my friend. Jesus is my friend. He made this world for us to live in.
He made this world
and gave us everything.
God gave us everything.
And all he has of us. Is we give each other love. Oh yeah. Don't go and talk about my father.
No, no, no.
'Cause God is my friend.
Y'all remember the young man that got killed by the Baltimore police? This is the attorney that felt justice for the family immediately. He came here to support the family because justice should be found immediately for the McDowell family.
Freddie Gray
died by the hands of the police. Jeremy McDowell died by the hands of police. When do we do our police job and negotiate a life and save a life that didn't take place? Let's give a, I want y'all to chant and scream for Billy Murphy, the attorney for the family.
Come on,
clap it up. Clap it up.
time for a history lesson. Y'all ready?
Go ahead, brother.
And I want you to hear this up on the roof, my brother.
There you go.
The police have never been a legitimate force in the black community.
Go ahead, go ahead.
Let's start it out where it began.
Go ahead.
What was the police job during slavery?
That's right. That's
the evil institution of slavery.
That
was their job.
That's right.
What was their job during the so-called Reconstruction?
That's right.
It was to thwart the Reconstruction, to keep it from happening. What was the police job during segregation? To enforce segregation.
That's right.
What was the police job during mass incarceration? To lock up as many black people as they possibly could. So let's be clear, folks. We don't have a legitimate police force in the black community anywhere in this country.
That's right. That's right.
And let me tell you this. When we do something that many of you have never done on a regular basis, we will be much more powerful, and that's the right to vote.
That's right.
There
that's
are
right.
people right. who you that's know, right. their household names who died
that's right.
so that we would have the
Go
right
ahead.
To vote.
Go
and
ahead.
So everybody in this crowd
that's
who is
right.
not registered to vote, shame on you.
Go ahead, brother.
We need to exercise our power. What is the point of saying we will drive out these unfair public officials if we don't vote?
Go
you
ahead,
can't drive them out like this.
That's
you
right.
can drive them out at the ballot box.
Go ahead. Go
now,
ahead.
It's illegal in the Murphy family for my kids not to be registered to vote. It's illegal in the Murphy family for my kids not to come out and vote in every election. So now what I want you to do is build on this.
That's right.
Build on
it.
Talk to your friends. Talk to your relatives. Talk to your neighbors. Take personal responsibility for bringing them out on the next one. And these marches will get bigger and bigger and better and better and scarier and scarier. Because let me tell you the dirty little secret here. When we get together like this, it scares the hell out of them.
Yes, sir. That's right.
And when we have small crowds, it only scares them a little bit.
Go ahead. That's right.
When we have medium-sized crowds, it only scares them a medium amount.
Go ahead.
But when we get big crowds, they get scared big time.
Go ahead.
When we get bigger crowds, they get scared to a bigger amount.
That's right.
When we get the entire community involved, oh, you're going to see some action.
Go ahead.
People are going to come out apologizing.
That's
People are
right.
going to come out prosecuting.
Go ahead.
People are going to come out making changes.
Go ahead.
Because that's black power.
Go ahead.
Now, I am not ashamed to say that we need black power.
Go
we
ahead.
Don't have enough power.
Go ahead.
Any
that's
fool
right.
can see that.
Go ahead.
And so black power is not illegitimate.
Go ahead.
Black power is entirely legitimate. Don't be ashamed to say you want black power. So I'm going to ask you a question. What do we want? The answer is black power.
That's
Here
right.
we go. What do we want?
Black power.
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 Let me ask you a question. We're going to make this criminal justice system work for us.
That's right.
It's been working against us our entire lives.
That's right.
I don't know a single person in the black community who has not had a close friend or relative, or seen a stranger, or themselves been the victim of police brutality. It's a national epidemic. And thank God for cell phone cameras. Say it again.
That's right.
Thank God for cell phone cameras. Because otherwise it would be one cover-up after another cover-up. Now, people are learning in this country. They say, wow, look at this, all this police violence. When did this start? Oh my God. How much of it is going on? Because they've never seen it before.
Right.
What they've seen isn't the videos. They've seen the police lie.
Right.
They've
right.
seen the police cover up.
That's right.
They see everything but the truth.
That's
but
right.
now is our time. Because we are going to tell the truth about this problem, and it's going to be backed up by video camera
that's
after
right.
video camera
right.
after
right.
video camera.
Right.
So my last word of advice to you. Keep those video cameras ready.
Yes,
as soon as you see something, turn them on. And don't turn them off until you've seen it all. You hear me?
Yes, sir.
Keep those video cameras rolling because without it, our word doesn't mean a damn.
That's
it
right.
It never has in court.
That's right.
You know what happens when a white police officer, a black police officer testifies against a truth-telling black man? He gets found guilty.
That's right. That's
they
right.
don't listen to us.
Go
if
ahead.
Barack Obama got prosecuted, and I hope that it doesn't happen, when his word comes up against the white folks' word, what do you think's gonna happen?
Yes, sir.
And who gonna be happy about it? That's not justice.
Yes, sir.
Justice is where every man's voice counts. Justice is where the truth comes out.
That's right.
Justice is something that we have to fight for.
That's right.
Because do we have justice now?
No, sir.
Let me hear you. Do we have justice now?
No.
Do we have justice now?
No.
I didn't hear you loud enough. Do we have justice now?
No.
Thank you. I'm going to work hard for this family.
Go ahead.
And I'm going to make sure justice is done.
That's right.
We have been conducting a thorough investigation.
Right.
Brother Bovell has been exceptionally helpful. How about a big hand for Brother Bovell?
That's right.
Brother Bovell knows what time it is.
Hello, everybody. Excuse my voice is a little hoarse right now.
Okay.
I just want to say to the man up there that you need to remember this face right here, because I ain't going nowhere. I ain't going nowhere. So remember my face and all these faces. Because we want justice and we going to get it. So when you take pictures, make sure you get a clear vision of this one, okay? But everybody, this is beautiful. I want y'all to give yourself a round of applause. Because without y'all, this wouldn't happen. This right here shows that y'all are just not going to stand for anything. We have to realize that that's what's going on in the world today. We have babies that's growing up. Look how many kids we got out of here. We have to set the road for our babies. We
that's
have
right.
to.
That's right.
We have to let, because if we don't now, it's going to get worse.
That's
we
right.
got to put our foot down now and stop being silent. That's what I'm saying. So just thank you, everybody, for coming out and doing this. We ain't going nowhere. We want justice. We're going to get justice.
Assalamu alaikum. I'm Student Minister Robert Muhammad, Wilmington, Delaware's local representative of the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan and of Mosque number 35. We are here today in Wilmington striving to get justice for Brother Bam Bam, who was shot 17 times, once with a shotgun and the other by three other white officers 16 times in September 23rd. What has happened now is none of the officers have been fired. They're still receiving pay from our tax dollars. And so nothing is being done. So we are marching today asking for the resignation of Matt Dinn, the Attorney General, and along with Bobby Cummings, the police chief. And so we have got to march, and it's justice or else. Unfortunately, we do not have the pastors nor the politicians with us, but we have the young people, and that's all we need in order to make change. So we are here, we're trying to make this thing happen until our brother Jeremy receives justice, then we will continue to fight in the right way and in a unified way in order to give our brother and his family exactly what they need. So we're on with justice is justice or else. That's our theme, and we're gonna stay on it until our brother Jeremy gets justice. Thank you, assalamu alaikum.
Ladies and gentlemen, you are on the steps of
of your tax dollars. You pay taxes for this building and for service to be served to the public. Safety, protect and serve. That's what the standards are. Jeremy McDowell was murdered on the 23rd of September 2015 by the police force of Wilmington, Delaware.
That's right, that's right.
And they have not come forward and stated what the investigation called for. I'm going to call the Honorable Robert Muhammad right up to the front to give himself some motivation to dress for my 35. Come on down, minister.
Come on, brother.
Assalamu alaikum. And listen, as Brother Fofell stated, yes, Bobby Cummings, yes, the mayor, but Matt Dean also. Because as you see in Chicago, what is happening, that's our blueprint. And if you notice, in San Francisco, another black man was murdered. And so if you notice, down in Louisiana, there were two black officers shot and killed a six-year-old Caucasian boy and mortal and wounded the father. The two black officers are in jail right now without bail. What's wrong with that picture? But the officers that are here that shot and murdered Bam Bam, they are still walking free. Something is wrong with that picture. So not just the mayor or the Cummings, but Matt Dinn got to go. And I'm saying, brothers and sisters, our pastors and our preachers, you got to stand up. When you go to church tomorrow, stand up in opposition that they got to stand on this issue for Bam Bam. Bam Bam is a symbol, as I just said. In my conclusion, why last week at Bethel did the governor come and offer the apology for slavery? Why last week? Because they know that this movement and justice for Bam Bam will continue. But the aim of the enemy is always to soothe us and to continue to soothe us, and then we run out and tell black folks everything is going to be all right. To apologize for slavery, hell, that has to be an atonement for if you want to apologize. So governor, you got to keep that apology. We want justice for our brother Bam Bam or else. Thank you for listening. Assalamu alaikum. Guys, give us something. This is Street Minister. I told you I knew this brother when he used to be bad. He turned bad into good, and he's fighting for his people. Talk to us, Big Keith.
Bring him out.
What I want the city of Wilmington to know, and the cameras and everything like that, if they wasn't flashing, I'd still be here.
Yes, sir.
Yesterday, we walked the streets, paved the streets, with Keandra, her mother, and her cousins, and the streets gave us love. But they say the streets are so cold. But I beg to differ. The only problem we really got right now is with the police. If we're going to unite black people, we need to unite and fight against the police. And when I say fight, I don't mean to go hand in hand with them. It's spiritual. This is a spiritual war.
That's right. That's
when you're dealing with spiritual warfare, you got to know how to engage your enemy. Right now, we're doing it civilly.
That's right.
The Constitution says that we can protest anything we want as long as we do it civil.
That's right.
So what we're doing is civil.
Right.
But what I want the city preachers to know, what I want the city politicians to know, is where the hell are y'all at?
Where you at?
Knock, knock.
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 Where you at?
And I got another message for you.
Where you at?
For the what's that? Gary Hill of Youngs, they changed the name so much it don't matter to me. Prison is prison. A cell is hell. And my sister right here, Shay Brown, son died in Gander Hill Prison.
That's right.
Due to the fact of an infection. When you die from an infection, that means you died slow. You don't get an infection and die like that. It's a process. And what the state has done is they allowed her son to die on their watch. When I went down there to see his body and get some property, they told me it was state property. So that means he belonged to them. So it's their fault why that brother died. If he was in my custody, he would have never died. So we want to hold the state.
Go ahead,
we want to hold the state on that too.
Go ahead,
we got brother Dope down in Dover, kicked in the face. Their excuse was he was trying to kick at his chest. That's a goddamn lie. I reject it and I don't accept it. And nobody in their right mind will accept that. So it's all across the board. It ain't just here in Wilmington. It's in Dover.
That's right.
It's in Chicago. And this right here now is the new black movement.
That's right.
I want y'all to know. Don't be ashamed, and you don't owe nobody apology for thinking black, talking black, walking black, living black. You are black.
Yes, sir.
Stand up to it and hold it. Don't let nobody try to do nothing against you.
Thank you.
I'm going to tell you like this, and I'm going to say it again.
Thank you, Pete.
Shea's son died in Gander Hill Prison. Neglect.
I would like to thank the community, and yes, you, the viewers, and everyone that's supported us today. Today, we have made history. We are asking for the resignation of the chief of police and the dismissal of the mayor for the city of Wilmington because they have let us down. They have let the community down. And without the community, there is no public safety. We cannot depend on them to patrol, protect our neighborhoods. This sister to my immediate right has done a fabulous job keeping this march and this rally and this information going. If we don't make the change in our own city, we will let ourselves down. Keandra, please let them know how you feel, and we're not going nowhere.
I have to start off by what my mom said. She said, if you don't stand for something, that means you're going to fall for anything. And we're not stopping, we're not backing down from anything that we're doing. We're just going to keep coming stronger and even harder. I'm asking for, my name is Keandra D. McDowell. I'm asking for Bobby Cummins to step down from his position, and he has to go. I'm asking for Mayor Dennis, since he promised me transparency in the case and I haven't gotten any of that, it's time for him to go too. And it's just, I'm here today for my brother, Jeremy McDowell, justice for him. Until we get justice, I'm not falling back, and nobody else is as well. Thank you.
This problem of police brutality has been with us since the beginning of America. The police have never been a legitimate presence in the black community. It started with their enforcement of slavery, which was absolutely immoral. Then they fought against the Reconstruction, again immoral. Then they fought against integration, again immoral. And then they fought for mass incarceration, finally immoral. We must make the police forces of our city a legitimate presence in the black community, a vital presence, a friendly presence, a helpful presence instead of what we get now. And the police have to understand they will be held accountable if I have anything to do about it.
I just reiterate as far as the Reconstruction is how they, the slave patrols and the reinforcement of the black codes and going up into the Great Compromise and all that, what they've done is basically save the system that is unjust to a certain segment of society, to a certain demographic. It's important if you want to have a civil society that people must trust the police or trust the law enforcement. If you cannot trust the law enforcement, you're going to have these issues continue.
Back in 1968, a very racist president named Richard Nixon started the so-called war on drugs. It was not meant to be a war on drugs. It was meant to be a war on black people, on brown people, and on poor people. And ever since that so-called war on drugs, we have lived in two systems, one white, one black. Now, I advocate the legalization of all drugs because drugs are a medical and psychological problem, not a criminal justice problem. And people say, that'll never work. And I say, it's working now. And they think I'm talking about Amsterdam or Switzerland or London. No, I'm talking about the white community in America, where the drug laws have never been enforced, where there is no war on drugs, where white people correctly get only treatment for their drug problems, while we get jailed, criminal records, and no jobs. Now, if that hasn't changed in the next 6 months, you're going to see more outbreaks. You're going to see more troubles. You're going to see more rioting. You're going to see more discontent, because we need this to change immediately. Not tomorrow, not Wednesday, but immediately. And until we get that, there will be no justice and there will be no peace.
As we continue this onward march towards justice, the question is unity. As you see, it's young people here. And the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan said, this is the Joshua generation. This is the generation that our ancestors prayed for. So they're not going to lay down. They're not going to sit down. We are going to continue this quest until we get justice. So we are with the youth. We are with this movement. And we will be here until justice is given for our brother Jeremy. And this is the tip of the iceberg here in Delaware. How many other Brother Jeremys are there? How many other ones that have died at the hands of the police and has not been put on camera? So we thank the one who took this video, and we thank YouTube, and we thank that whole social media. And so let us go on and get justice for our brother, Brother Jeremy.
And by the way, our minister is fighting another fight.
That's right.
And that is the war against Muslims in America.
That's right.
That is the effort by the Donald Trumps and the other Republican candidates to keep Muslims out of America, to make this yet another group that will face discrimination in America. We must stand up with our Muslim brothers, and we must fight for their freedom, their dignity, their peace in this country. The vast majority, 99% of the Muslims in America, are peaceful, law-abiding citizens. And when we demonize the religion of Islam, we play right into the hands of ISIS, because they are trying to paint us as an intolerant country, which is prejudiced against the religion of Islam. No, we're not. The friends of that religion. We're the friends of the peaceful members of the Muslim community. And we will not be divided by the Donald Trumps of the world.
Thank you.
Come on, brother.
Thank you, brother. Thank you, brother. Good work, man. Love you, brother.
I know what you're
saying. Yes, sir. That's right. That's right.
Don't be afraid. God is with us. All right? Stand up, and God is with us. All right? Let us pray.
Let us pray, family.
Oh Allah, we seek thy refuge from anxiety and grief. We seek thy refuge from lack of strength and laziness. We seek thy refuge from cowardice and ungodliness. And we seek thy refuge from being overpowered by debt and the oppression of men. Oh Allah, suffice us that which is lawful. Keep us away from that which is prohibited. And with thy grace, make us free from want of what is besides thee. Oh Allah, bless and protect the Madol family and all of us who seek justice for our brother Jeremy. Be with us, guide us, and protect us. And we ask you, in the name of your righteous servants and in the name of your exalted Christ, we pray. Amen.
Oh, don't go and talk about my father. Talk about my father. God is my friend. Jesus is my friend. He made this world for us to live in. And gave us everything, and all he asks of us is we give each other love. Oh yeah, don't go and talk about my father, 'cause God is my friend, Jesus is my friend. He loves us whether or not we know it. And he'll forgive all our sins.
Forgive our sins.
Oh, yeah. And all he asks of us, oh, yeah, is we give each other love. Oh, yeah. Love your mother.
She bore you.
Love your father.
It worked for you.
Love your sister.
She's good to you.
Love your brother.